Honorable members on the dais and my dear friends, I am Mrs. Shubhra Ghosh. My qualification is MCOM B.Ed. I am a teacher in Sahyadri Junior College in the Commerce Faculty. I belong from Mumbai, Maharashtra. My topic is how a teacher can channelize the influence of social media on students positively. Aims and objectives: to use social networking sites to help students in career guidance, to influence students to use social media positively, to use social media in teaching learning process, to create a positive impact by videos and profiles of role models to help students in de-education of internet. Social media. Introduction of this topic. Social media, a tool of 21st century, is more popular with the younger generation. Social media tools like Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, Quora, Twitter, Instagram are not only stimulating but also motivating the younger generation. So as a teacher, how we can channelize the influence of social media to benefit the students in the teaching learning process? Synergetic effect in cross-culture teaching learning process globally. This is my first point in this topic. Synergetic effect means working together. All the students from different cultural background and from different country can come together in one platform globally. The emergence of social networking sites like Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram has revolutionized teaching methods. Blogs also can be used to collaborate on projects and receive rapid feedback. Social media sites like YouTube, WhatsApp, Google also connect people globally. A very popular social networking site is MOOC, means Massive Open Online Courses. 40 million students, people are already learning there. There are many free courses and students can find traditional course material, film lectures, problem sets, social media discussions among professors and teachers can be done in this platform. My next point is visual library and social networking. Visual library is a collection of photos, paintings, patterns, artworks and colors that can be kept digitally. It is mostly used by photographers and artists. Those students who wants to become an artist or a photographer, they can know what to avoid and how to develop our own sense of taste. You can see this slide, social networking. From this slide, you can understand that social networking sites like LinkedIn, how it can help students to create their own professional and marketable profile. You can see 10 points, 10 skills are written over there, which is mentioned by the LinkedIn profile. And also you can see a chart over here. As I'm a commerce teacher, I can guide the students that after 12th standard, what the students, which career options are there, what career they can choose as per their aptitude. This I have got it from the Google. I already teach entrepreneurship development, and in that a topic is related to Startup India, a startup which is started by Indian government, which aims to provide microfinance, low interest rate loans to entrepreneurs from low socio-economic background to build up 10 lakh mobile app startups. In this slide, brand awareness, I can tell you that students can create a marketing strategy campaign advertisement with the help of LinkedIn. Create their own unique image by videos of role models like Arunima Sinha, amputee mountain climber Malala Yousafzai, the Nobel laureate, who was the youngest Nobel laureate, Medha Patkar, social activist Kiran Bedi, the first female IPS officer Lakshmi Agarwal, who was attacked by acid. You can also show them the profiles of great entrepreneurs in LinkedIn like Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Ratan Tata, Mukesh Ambani. Life skill sessions like adaptability, communication skills, leadership quality, positive thinking, creative and critical thinking can be helped with videos of TED Talk and YouTube channels. These channels can help the students to handle negative peer pressure. Seeing friends hooking up, it seems as a common activity and it's not a very big deal. So as teachers, we have to tell them about the sexually transmitted diseases and about pregnancy. We also have to tell them about what is the good touch, bad touch, child abuse and safe sex. I have shown you brainstorming sessions. Brainstorming sessions can be done with the help of social media like Facebook, WhatsApp, YouTube. Here I have shown you mood boards, which is usually done by the designer teams or in film divisions for generating ideas. Mind mapping by Tony Bujan, who is the inventor. Mind mapping is a visual information management tool that helps to structure, organize, memorize, arrange and brainstorm. Here we can generate different ideas and we can also brainstorm ideas, and it is useful for lectures, assignments, projects. Facebook can be used for projects, assignments by forming a group. Students can display their writing skills through blogs. Students can collect lots of information. Students can upload their videos of their projects in the YouTube. Google Document is very popular with students and teachers to collaborate assignments and projects. De-addiction of internet, or you can say detox from the digital platform. It can be helped by creating hobbies like reading, sports, playing musical instruments. We can also help the students with concentration and meditations. We can also include counseling sessions. I have myself conducted many counseling sessions in my college, which was very fruitful, and I have got lot of good feedbacks. Even Dr. Ajay Dudhane has his de-addiction center, where he has helped a lot of students from the age group of 13 to 30. Now I want to conclude my presentation. Social media has its benefit and can be healthy and positive medium if not used. As a teacher, we can help students to combat boredom and differentiate between the real and virtual world, and help students positively use the digital platform. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to put forward my presentation.